Gordon was cross.
Why should Henry have a new shape? He grumbled. A shape good enough for me is good enough for him. He goes gallivanting off, leaving us to do his work, and comes back saying how happy he feels. It's disgraceful. And there's another thing. Henry whistles too much. No respectable engine ever whistles loudly at stations. It isn't wrong, but we just don't do it. Poor Henry didn't feel happy anymore. Never mind, whispered Percy. I'm glad you're home again. I like your whistling. Goodbye, Henry, called Gordon. We're glad to have you with us again, but remember what I said. Later, Henry stopped at Edward's station. Hello, Henry, said Edward. You look splendid. I was pleased to hear your happy whistle yesterday. Thank you, Edward, smiled Henry. Shh! Can you hear something? It sounds like Gordon, said Edward, and it ought to be Gordon, but Gordon never whistled like that. It was Gordon. He came rushing down the hill at a tremendous rate. He didn't look at Henry, and he didn't look at Edward. He screamed straight through the station and disappeared. Well, said Edward. It isn't wrong, chuckled Henry, but we just don't do it. And he told Edward what Gordon had said.
Meanwhile, Gordon screeched along the line. The noise was awful. Station, everyone covered their ears. Sir Topham Hatt covered his ears, too.
Take him away, he bellowed, and stop that noise.
Gordon puffed sadly away, but he wouldn't stop whistling until two fingers climbed up and knocked his whistle valve in place.
That night, Gordon slunk into the shed. He was glad it was empty.
It isn't wrong, murmured Henry to no one in particular, but we just don't do it.
No one mentioned whistles.
Next morning, Henry was enjoying himself enormously. I feel so well. I feel so well, he sang. Trickety trot, hummed his coaches.
Then he saw some boys on a bridge.
Beep, beep, hello, he whistled. Oh, he called. The boys didn't wave and take his number. They thought it fun to drop stones on him instead.
They've broken our glass! They've broken our glass! Cried the coaches.
The passengers weren't hurt, but they were cross.
Call the police!
No, said the driver. Leave it to Henry and me.
What will you do? They asked.
Can you keep a secret?
Yes, yes.
Well then, said the driver, Henry is going to sneeze at those boys.
Lots of people were waiting at the station just before the bridge. They wanted to see what would happen.
Henry has plenty of ashes, said the driver. Please keep all windows shut till we've passed the bridge.
Henry's as excited as we are, aren't you, old fellow?
Henry felt more stuffed up than excited.
Soon they could see the boys, and they all had stones.
Are you ready, Henry? Said the driver. Sneeze hard when I tell you. Now,
he said.
Well done, Henry, laughed his driver.
Henry went home, hoping that next time he saw Gordon and the boys, they would have learned not to be so mean.